Good morning. Welcome to Sunday School Simplified. If you have never joined us before, this is where we take our Sunday school lesson and squeeze it into a short, simple. I broke my foot. So I am coming to you on a stilt basically right now. But nonetheless, we are here. We have been talking about Jesus as the bread of life. And it's a kind of a two-parter this week since we missed last week, but Jesus as the bread of life. How do we make bread? From dough, right? But dough doesn't always make bread. It can make donuts. It can make sweet rolls. It can make pizza. But Jesus as the dough of life doesn't really sound that great. But as the bread of life, even back when he was called the bread of life. Bread was life, literally, for so many people. It was their sustenance. It was how they were able to survive and nourish their bodies. And it can come still in many forms all around the world. And that's the whole point, is that Jesus says the bread of life is so many things to so many people. And it doesn't have to be the same thing to everyone. But the bottom line is that he is sustenance. And what that means is that he gives us life. He allows us to be strong. He nourishes our hearts and our minds and our bodies to find strength and get through hard times. So I wanted you guys to think about that. And also, we have been using the book of John and chapter 6 throughout this month for scripture if you want to read along. And specifically verse 27 says, "Do not work for food that spoils, but for food that endures to eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For on him God the Father has placed his seal of approval." And the whole thing about that, as we talked about a little bit previously, is that Jesus fed a huge group of people, like 5,000 people, and entertained them. And by that, I mean that what he started out with was a meal of leftovers, really, that could barely feed one. And he made it feed 5,000 people. And some of these people were non-believers. So to them, it was mere entertainment. So he fed them, he entertained them, and then he moved on. Well, they followed him. And this verse, what this verse is saying is that he said, "You did not come to me for food and entertainment." Like, that's not what I'm here for. Food perishes. Entertainment goes away, doesn't last forever. Look for things that endure forever, for eternal life that is everlasting. And that is Jesus. And the things that endure forever through him are love and kindness and compassion. These are the things that we need to look for and seek in him that will allow us to not only survive in this world, because there are so many things against us that are, you know, really testing our patience and testing how far our love goes and our compassion. But through him, we're reminded that these are the things that matter. These are what allows humanity to survive and the things that we need to focus on. And then through him, it will give us everlasting life and once we go to heaven. And what I did with the kids this week was we made this little bag, because also, you know, the food that endures to eternal life, I mentioned the compassion and the love. Those are the things that people think of first. But I also thought about it as, what about our worries and the things that scare us? Those are things we don't think of as food because it's not like appealing, but these are also things that, even if we don't want to, we seek them or they find us in this life. And these are the things that weigh us down. But these are the things that we need to know are perishable. They are not forever. And if we worry about something, it's going to happen the way it's meant to happen, whether we worry about it or not. And by worrying is only going to wear us down. It could make us tired. It could lead us to bad decisions. And that thing is going to do the exact same thing it was going to do whether you worried about it or not. So we made this bag, and in this bag are all of our worries and fears. Something has been on my heart. The people of Afghanistan right now, excuse me, the women and the children, and even our American soldiers that are in harm's way trying to help them. That has been so heavy on my heart, but it is happening. It's been happening. It's happening right now. And unfortunately, it's going to continue to happen, whether I worry about it or not. And it's good to be compassionate about it and have empathy and pray for the goodness in it and a good outcome. But it's not good for me to sit here and worry about it and be distracted by the worry, not focus on my family and my life and things that are important. Also, not be distracted and worried about it and keep me from doing something. There are things that we can do. UNICEF, you can donate your airline miles to getting these women and children and people out of the country. There are active things we can do and you can sign petitions. There are things that cost zero money, including praying, that you can do, that if you were worried and you focused on the thing that is perishable, it's going to keep you from what endures forever and will is the thing that is going to get us through it and get them through it. So I wrote that on my little piece of paper and I put it in this bag, and I know that it has God's seal of approval on it and that Jesus will get me through it. I implore you to make a bag if you want to, or just hypothetically write down figuratively your worries, what scares you, what's bothering you, and put it in this bag. And know that Jesus has you. And pray about it. Because this life is not forever. And the worries of this life are not forever. The things that we fill ourselves with and distract us from God, that give us momentary pleasure, are not forever. He is forever. So I'd like to end this in a prayer for everyone in the entire world, for peace and comfort and safety, and you, your health and safety, as everyone is going back to school. And it is just scary and crazy times, but He is here for us, and I am here for you. That is Sunday School Simplified, and I hope you have a blessed week.